He was the total epitome of the Renaissance man, the universal man, the person who is able to see all sorts of things in life, from anatomy to zoology, from painting to engineering, and say, these aren't separate fields, these are all tied together.
Was there anybody else like him who you've ever discovered?
You know, the Renaissance did produce a lot of other Renaissance men, and even since then there have been people like Benjamin Franklin, who tried to know everything.
Of course, but technically, any male who was alive during that period was a Renaissance man. The tailor, the barber, right? They were all Renaissance men.
Well, it's interesting that during the Renaissance, the tailor and the barber also loved art. They did blend disciplines,
really?
Especially in Florence, where you'd have the gold beaters and the jewelry makers there next to the fabric makers, next to the architects, next to the artists, and they all worked together. And that's something we have to do today, is like in our universities, in our schools, and even in our businesses, not try to say these are separate disciplines.
These are silos.
But let people work together.
That's so fascinating. I never would have thought
Florence was so wonderful. It was very tolerant of all sorts of people, and it had different types of artisans. There was a new middle class emerging because people were getting kind of rich. They needed art. They needed architecture. And people were working together across disciplines to create art and engineering that tied together.